Stathi, just because I don't follow these things well enough to just know the answer, could you tell us what the objective is for having locomotives ready opening day and cars? Are there any new ones being inserted? Where are we on all that?
Okay, well, in terms of the locomotive fleet, there's some extensive work happening right now. Obviously, 168 stands at the ready, has its annual complete. There's the annual inspections on the primary fleet of K-36s and the K-27 that are going on as well. There's extensive work happening on locomotive 488 with the replacement of the lower half of the rear tube sheet. There was evidence of fire cracking and wastage on that. That's something that I've been assisting the Chama shop with. Special Projects has helped with making the sheets, and this is a good training opportunity to do some real heavy boiler work, the heavy sheet work inside the firebox of that locomotive. Locomotive 489 obviously is completing its new smoke box, 1472 and oil conversion, and that locomotive will be ready for the season as well. Locomotive 487 is getting its cap inspection, its five-year inspection completed at this time. It needs its cab put back on, plumbing, etc. It does have some conditions that may render it less reliable, so it will be primarily used as a backup locomotive for the season. Locomotive 484 stands at the ready. It does need some timing. The radius rod on it, we had that incident with it towards the end of the season last year. So a different radius rod was put on it, but it needs to be timed before this season comes up. The K-27, basically almost everything is complete on it at this time. A lead truck rebuild was undertaken, as well as some additional work, a couple tubes replaced, some stay bolts, et cetera. And so work is moving along on that. It's critical to have all our locomotive assets available to us every season. The reason why is because that distributes the service days adequately across the fleet, and it decreases the cost and duration of the maintenance that's necessary. If you do the math, if every locomotive's in service and used relatively equally in the primary locomotive fleet, you get about 5,000 to 6,000 miles per year per locomotive. That's not too extensive, but as soon as you have one of them out of rotation, all of them need to start taking more and more of that burden, and then you start wearing them out quicker, and you have larger amounts of work during the off season. One thing when it comes to maintenance here at the C&TS is that our human resources are finite and inelastic, in that there's only so much work that we can achieve during an off season, and off season is a very precious resource. And so being able to have all the locomotives in service and ready to go allows us to be able to distribute this work over multiple years and be more effective. So that's part of the reason why Special Projects is helping the Chama shop with the steam locomotive work on 489 and 488 is to ensure readiness for the season.
Okay, what about cars?
Cars. The car shop, all the annuals are done at this time. Marvin and Company have done the step upgrade. I don't want to take his thunder. Obviously, once he gets on the call, he can talk about that. But the fold down steps that were pioneered on the premium cars, that's something that has been applied to the rest of the coach fleet. And they're also working on the annual inspections for the cars that will be used in the photo charters and school trains at this time. So that work has been moving along nicely, and now they're working on the premium cars that Candelaria has so graciously helped us with in terms of funding. So basically in terms of cars, we basically stand at the ready. There's a little more work to be done, and hopefully we can get pretty far on that premium car. I'll let Marvin speak more to that once he can get on.
What's going on with the replacement car for the existing tourist fleet?
So, talking about the new premium cars?
No, the normal tourist cars.
Coach.
Okay.
And when will we be in a position to decide what to do with the spare car that is generated by that process?
Yeah. Okay. So we have two car bodies that are built and waiting for us to turn into coaches with the clear story roof design, like our normal coach fleet. at this time, because of funding, basically that project has been put on ice. We have the frames for building additional car bodies are at our contractor in Farmington, as are those two car bodies that are complete. Basically, at this time, we're completing the premium cars prior to getting into the coach build. Now, if funding were to allow, it would certainly be desirable to jumpstart the new coach build project and get those to be able to help start phasing out the flat top cars with the fish belly underframes. There are several other institutions that are interested in purchasing those car bodies. They have expressed interest even as recently as just 2 days ago. But being is that we don't have any of those new car bodies in service at this time, it's not desirable to give up any capacity that we have. So basically, as soon as funding and manpower allows, we can get back into that.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Any other questions for Stathi? Okay, Marvin, could you come on and tell us about maintenance and repair? Thanks for being here this morning.